That means about 2,000 to 8,000 kinds on board, so about 16,000 animals, most of which were quite small.
Right.
Median size would have been about the size of a rat.
Now for some math. Putting all 16,000 animals in cages, which would average 50 centimeters by 50 centimeters by 30 centimeters, would require 1,200 cubic meters of space, or the equivalent of 14.4 railway stock cars. That's not even 3% of the space available. Even if we add a million species of insects in tiny cages, that would only be another 1,000 cubic meters, or 12 stock cars. Now we're up to 5%.
Besides the animals on Noah's Ark, there had to have been enough food and water to last about a year. That's a lot of kibble.
Yeah, that's right. Let's assume it was regular food as opposed to something miraculously provided like manna. Right. What would all those animals eat? Skeptics point out that some animals eat mostly fruit in the wild, so how would that last a whole year? But actually, most mammals kept in captivity can be sustained on the same sort of dried foods used to feed domestic livestock and pets.
When you go on a trip, you probably pack fairly light.
Right.
If you take food, it's likely things with concentrated nutritional value that take up less space, like protein bars.
Right.
Noah could have taken concentrated foods along with compressed and dried foodstuffs.
But not the protein bars, right?
No, more likely things like grain, dried meat and fish, dried fruits, and compressed hay. Back to the feasibility study for more calculations. Assuming the food was about 80% dry by mass, the total mass needed would have been 2,500 tons. Hmm. If it was 90% dry, only 2,200 tons.
Right, and that sounds like a lot, but it would have been no more than 6,000 cubic meters,
right,
or about 15% of the total volume of the ark. That plus the animals in cages, and we're up to not quite 18%. This is assuming that none of the animals were dormant for any part of the year. God could have caused all the animals to hibernate for a year, but he didn't need to. Of course, any amount of dormancy during the flood would mean even less food needed.
What about water? Perhaps Noah could have collected rainwater, but assuming he didn't, the amount of water needed on the ark for that year-long sojourn would have been about 4.07 megaliters, or a little less than 900,000 gallons.
Right.
Again, that sounds like a lot, but it only amounts to 9.4% of the ark's total volume. So what are we up to now?
About 27%.